A suspect in Daniel Morcombe's disappearance committed suicide days after he was questioned by police. His inquest has heard at the time he vanished, a number of pedophiles were on the Sunshine Coast hunting for boys.
Each day the Morcombe family has come to court desperate to hear what happened to Daniel.
It's very draining, but I think we're finally, through process of elimination, are getting closer to the information that we want to hear.
Still, they're bracing for the weeks ahead.
It's very unnerving. It won't be a witness or a police officer just 4 metres from us. It'll be the person of interest.
Detective Senior Constable Ross Hutton told the inquest about one of those people, known as P5. The man had spent 8 years behind bars for abducting and sexually assaulting a young boy. He was released a month before Daniel was taken and returned a month later.
We're getting closer. We're chiselling away.
The man told police he was at a friend's house at the time, but Detective Hutton detailed phone records which left 3 hours unaccounted for.
He also told the inquest of two pedophiles who had attracted authorities' attention. They told police that on the day Daniel disappeared, they were on the Sunshine Coast, trawling surf clubs, looking for young boys.
They went to Malulabar, met some boys and arranged to have pizza with them, he said. They didn't have a history of violence. Two other men who owned a white van and blue car also were interviewed. One of them suicided 3 days later. Two similar vehicles were seen in the area at the time of Daniel's disappearance, but the inquest heard there was no evidence linking either man to Daniel. On the Sunshine Coast, Leonie Mellor, 10 News.